In Milgram's study, he obviously could not tell the participants that it was a study on obedience to authority. Instead, he told them it was a study of memory. And here you can see the original advertisement that Milgram used. When the participant arrived, there were always two other people present. One was Milgram, who was the experimenter, and then there was another person. And Milgram had these two people draw slips to determine whether they were going to be a teacher or they were going to be a learner. Unbeknownst to the participant, the person who was with Milgram was actually a Confederate, meaning that person was working for Milgram. Therefore, when they chose slips, Milgram had arranged it that the real participant was always the teacher and the learner was the Confederate, or a person who was working with Milgram. Now remember, the participant thought this was a study on memory. So Milgram told the participant that he was going to read a series of words and that the other participant, the learner, who was the Confederate, would have to remember those words. Every time the learner would get a word incorrect, the teacher was to deliver a shock. The learner was to memorize those word lists and provide correct answers. And during the study, Milgram, who was the experimenter, observed the teacher and provided instruction. So here the teacher thought that he was to read words and deliver shocks, but in fact, Milgram was testing that participant's level of obedience as well as his willingness to inflict pain to the learner. Now remember, the learner was a Confederate working for Milgram, and he did not receive any actual shocks. And he actually didn't even respond to the word lists. All of the responses were pre-programmed. And finally, Milgram served as the authority figure in this study. And he was positioned next to the teacher while the teacher was reading the words and supposedly delivering the shocks. So we have the teacher, the learner, and Milgram. Now let's go into a little more details on the specific methods of the experiment. The teacher and learner were to be tested in separate rooms, but before the learner left, the teacher actually was hooked up to the shock machine and received a very small shock. And this was to let the teacher know that the shock generator actually worked, and also so the teacher was aware of the type of shocks that the learner would experience. Milgram instructed the teacher to provide a shock for every incorrect response, and they would start at the low end of the shock generator, and with each consecutive incorrect response, the teacher had to provide a shock, and that went up on the shock generator to 450 volts. So here's the experimental arrangement. Here we have the teacher who is sitting in front of the voltage machine. And notice that the learner is in a separate room. Remember, the learner is the Confederate, and when the study began, he actually just left the room. All of the responses were pre-programmed. Notice, too, that Milgram was sitting near the teacher as he was observing that person.